Hi, welcome to this series of videos where we'll be exploring coding and typography together. And before we jump into real coding, I want to take some time to talk about the tool we'll be using and some of the learning resources you can use. So here I am on p5js.org website. So p5js is a JavaScript library for creative coding with a focus on making coding accessible and inclusive for artists, designers, educators, beginners, and anyone else. It's a free and open source because we believe software and the tools to learn it should be accessible to everyone. So I've been using p5js for a few years, and before that, processing, which are closely related to each other. And what I really love about it is it's very visually oriented. As a designer who wants to learn how to code, it can feel very daunting if you have never done any programming before. But p5js, it's built around drawing things on screen. So I feel it makes it easier when you get started. And also there are a lot of great learning resources online. I mean, JavaScript itself is a very popular language. So you will see lots and lots of tutorials and books on different subjects. But p5js itself has also a great community and great learning resources as well. And the easiest way to get started with p5 is by using their online editor. So you can either click here or go to editor menu here. And you'll be directed to editor.p5js.org. So this is basically code editor running inside your browser. So all you need to start coding is an internet connection and a web browser. Then you can start typing your code. So there's already some basic code included in this empty sketch. So let me just run it by clicking this play button. And you will see the result on the right side. So what it's doing is creating this drawing canvas, which is 400 pixels wide and 400 pixels tall. And then setting the background color to somewhat light gray. You can stop and rerun. If you change the value, let's say I want this to be a bit darker. So I want to change to say 100. Then you can rerun it. Then you will get the updated result. Also, if you check this auto refresh box, every time you make some changes, it will automatically rerun your sketch. And if you look around the menu, we have file, and here's an example section, which are sorted by different subjects, some basic examples, or if you are making something for mobile devices, here are a couple examples too, or generating sound, different types of input, keyboard, mouse, etc., and 3D graphics, typography, and all that. So you can maybe open a couple here, even if you don't know how they work, just to see what's possible, you know, just to get some ideas. And when you have some sketches, you can save. To be able to do that, you will need to sign up. It's free. You can sign up. And when you log in with the account you make on this website, you'll be able to save and retrieve sketches later. So let me log in with my account. I've linked with my GitHub account, which is optional. You don't have to do that, but that's what I'm going to do now. Then now you'll be able to save. And when you save, you can open. So these are some of the sketches that I made before. And you can open it and keep editing later. And you can change the name of your sketch. It just comes with some kind of random combination of words, but you can change that. Simple example. The project saved. Then when I go to open again, here's my sketch. If you want to continue with the sketch, but not using web browser, but using other code editors like Visual Studio Code, Brackets, and Atom, etc., then you can just simply download. And it downloads as a zip file. And when I open it in my Visual Studio Code, you will see that there are multiple files that are linked properly. So you don't have to do anything other than just open the sketch.js file and continue to add your own code. If this sounds like too complicated for you, you don't have to do this, right? Because we can just keep working using this online editor, which is perfectly fine. Let me go back to p5js website again. So I like you to spend some time, just look around. Maybe look at the get started page, reference. There are a lot of functions you can use to draw and do other mathematical operations. You don't need to memorize any of these here. If you keep practicing, it will eventually come very natural to you. Those things that you'll be using over and over again, no worries. But just look around the website and just get a basic feel for it. And in terms of learning resources, definitely start with their official website, p5js.org. And I also want to suggest that you look at this codepen.io website where people share their small web sketches. So if you search p5js, there are like hundreds, if not thousands, of different projects, sketches people made. And let me click on one of these. Then here is a full source code to create this graphics. So if you have time and will to study this, there will be a lot you can learn from it. So it's very similar to p5js online editor. It's also free, and you can save your own sketches as well. And you can, of course, use search engines like DuckDuckGo or Google.com to search with keywords like p5js. As you can see, people have already searched different keywords, p5js mouse pressed, keyboard, etc. And obviously YouTube, right? Coding Train. So Coding Train is a channel where Dan Schiffman has a lot of amazing videos on p5js, a lot of p5js videos, and processing and some other programming concepts as well. So definitely subscribe and watch his videos. I mean, if you search anything p5js, I mean, you will see his videos on top result anyways. And if you're a type of person who learn new concepts through reading, like reading books, then getting started with p5js is a very small and light book for complete beginners. I mean, it only deals with very basic things, but still, if you want to have something to read, this could be a good place to start. And another book that I want to suggest is Generative Design. This is more advanced, but comes with beautiful code examples. And if you're only interested in code, then you can simply just download whole code package or look at the source code just online in the browser. So if you're looking for something a little more advanced, maybe after you learn the basics of p5js and basic programming concepts, that I highly recommend this book. Okay, so that's about it for this video. And I'll see you in the next video where we'll be drawing lines and shapes and drawing some simple letter forms.